What's that now? Don't like the cold? Can't stand today. We have a ritual to perform, you and I. Here. Wear this. It belonged to my daughter. Good. Today, I speak your name, girl. But will the goddess speak it back? Normally, it would be the mother who declares, if you had one. The whole village would attend, and matriarchs perform the ritual. But we are outcasts. Even so, we keep the tribe's rituals. Otherwise, we might become like the faithless old ones who turned their backs on the goddess. But their wickedness doomed them. To us, we're left the splendors of creation. Beasts of air, water, earth, and steel. It is one thing to hunt a beast. Another to hunt a machine. You must be humble and respect their power. I will teach you this one day. What is she doing here? Does she mean to forbid the ritual?
No, 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 off your knees. It's nearly time. And yes, you may speak to me.
You came to bless the naming.
Have not 6 months gone by since we entrusted her to you?
But we are outcasts.
You by choice, and she, well... I am a high matriarch, Rost. I bless whom I choose.
Then you honor us.
Yes, yes, now go, and be ready to declare. Go! Oh, Mother, this child needs a name by which to know her. That your love may warm her life as the rising sun warms all the earth. Speak her name! And so her name is blessed.
Stop this at once! What have you done?
I've blessed the naming of a child.
Stubborn woman, you call that curse a child? What did she tell you about his birth, outcast? Answer!
I've done only what you asked.
To raise it, yes. We said nothing of love.
Enough!
And you, blessing its name like it was one of the...
I know my duty to them. And to you.
Without consultation.
I'm here. And wherever you go, I will follow.
Well, that was quite a beginning cutscene. I got hired for now. Turned to very hard once I get to know what's going on. What? Why? Why does it? All right, so got a TV that can do both of, well, this is probably for PlayStation Pro, so I don't got that, but I do have an HDR TV, so I don't know why it's not working. However, it's all right. Well, once again, welcome to Horizon Zero Dawn, a PoboBaked playthrough part one. Now, without further delay, let's jump into this. I'm super excited. It's really good. The cutscene was really, really good as well. Beautiful. Yeah.
See if you can find some more. Hmm? Well done, that's a good boy. Children, come with me. She's an outcast to be shunned.
We have just hit peak awesomeness. What? Time of day?
Ew, rats.
Till we get some good legs. Whoa!
Looks tight, but I can get through. This must be a ruin of the metal world. One of the old places. Never go in places like this. But I have to find a way out.
Well, let's hope shit doesn't go down.
There's something up ahead. What's that? A tactic.
Oh. Don't know what it is.
There's something shiny there.
Wow.
A metal door. Closed. Maybe this device I found can help. How do I get it open? More lights. Shape. It's connected to the door somehow. Changed color.
We're going places now.
The door changed color too.
Oh no, what did I? Damn it. Black and white too. Let's go for Ned.
What's that? It's got a device.
You think I want it this way? It's the best I can do. He's right behind you. Hi! Happy birthday, Isaac. Daddy sure does love his little big man. Look, Daddy can't be there with you and Mom, but we can still have a party, right? Sure we can.
Show me again.
I can do. He's right behind you. Hi.
Hi.
Happy birthday, Isaac. Daddy sure does love his little big man. Look, Daddy can't be there with you and Mom, but we can still have a party, right? Sure we can.
Happy birthday, Isaac. Daddy sure does love his little big man.
That kind of escalated. What's going on here?
I mean, seriously? Record our thoughts for posterity? Great idea, Director Evans. Like, I haven't done enough for posterity already. Like, I wouldn't be here like this if not for posterity. I'm done with posterity. Posterity can go.
I knew we'd be forever.
Want to make sure I get all of those.
You don't belong down there. Come. Such places are forbidden, Aloy.
I fell in.
They are of the metal world. What is that on your face?
Nothing.
Did you find it down there?
No.
Give it to me.
No.
Aloy. Such things are dangerous.
No!
Well, if you're gonna go sneaking away from home, you'll need to know how to survive in the wild. Come, Aloy. Home now. And starting tomorrow, you will learn to hunt. Muttering to that plaything. We descend to the valley now. Follow. The wilds can be dangerous, Aloy. You will need to stay close and do as I say.
I know.
Now. You're still scratched up from that fall you took yesterday. So let's start there. Take this medicine pouch. I'll show you how to fill it. See this plant over here? It's called salvebrush. Come, gather its berries in your pouch. Good. Now eat the berries. They may taste bitter, but they could save your life. Always keep your pouch full of medicinal berries, and flowers, and plants.
Where are we?
This valley is just a part of All Mother's embrace. The Nora tribe watches these lands and keeps out the most dangerous machines, usually. Further downriver, we'll find a herd of machines, and I will teach you how to hunt.
Are they dangerous?
All machines are dangerous, Aloy. Their power must be respected. But I will be beside you. Aloy, a machine's coming. Crouch and follow me into the tall grass. There. Now stay low.
Little one.
No, Aloy. Such machines are called Watchers. You must learn to avoid their gaze. If you are to survive in the wilds, I will show you. Listen close and do as I do. Stay still. Wait for it to pass. Now keep low and follow me across the trail to that tall grass. This way. The slower you move, the quieter you'll be. And crouched walking is quieter than upright. Wait for it. That's the last of them. Let's move on. Did well. They didn't see or hear you. Now stay close. That herd should be just ahead. Ignore him.
But why is he up there? He's smiling at us.
Teb! Get back where you belong! Teb! Where are you?
Ignore him. We are outcasts and he is of the tribe.
Maybe he doesn't like the tribe.
Then he is a fool. Come now, let's find that herd. Follow. There. See them? These are called Striders.
Ha! Get!
Why'd you chase them off?
To show you how some machines startle easily if they detect you and run away. They're best approached by stealth. Don't worry. We'll catch up with them further down the valley. You'll see. Now, I want you to find some rocks that fit the cup of your hand.
Why?
Do as I say, Aloy, and gather the rocks. I will show you how to use them. Good. That's it. Those will do. Follow. Stop wasting time. There's the herd. All right, it's time to throw some rocks.
But rocks can't hurt machines, right?
No, but they can distract them, draw them into traps. Like that watcher over there. It must be dealt with, or it will warn the herd and send them running before we get in range.
Warn them? How?
The machines speak to each other, Aloy, unless they are first silenced. Now you stay here on the ridge. On my signal, throw rocks and draw the watcher over to me. Wait for my signal. Aloy, throw a rock near me. Come, girl, it's safe now. Harvest a kill so I can teach you how to make arrows. Good. Now, gather stalks of ridgewood from the plants over there. Use the stalks as arrow shafts, and metal shards for arrowheads. Good. You'll never run out of arrows if you know how to craft what you need. Let's put those arrows to use. Follow. Stay low in the grass, and be quiet. It's time to make your first kill, Aloy. The Strider, one of the weaker machines. But even a weak machine can kill a hunter, if she's careless. You must study your prey. Its hide is thick, but there are spots where it is vulnerable. Like its eye. Can you guess another?
On its back. Is that a weakness?
Shits. How did you guess that?
The device. It showed me.
That plaything? Stop playing games. Now, take down that Strider. Target the eye or the canister. And if it charges, be ready to roll out of the way.
Again! Keep firing!
You did well today, but you have much to learn. Tomorrow, we train again. What was that?
That boy! The one running the Brave Trails!
Follow Aloy! Quick!
I need to see their paths. Almost there.
I know, man. I'm blowing my own mind at the same time.
Wait. Oh, Mother, bless that girl. Bless you both.
Boy!
She saved me. I just wanted...
Boy! Seal your lips. They are outcasts, both. And she is motherless. Come now. Back to Mother's heart.
That boy should not have spoken to us. It's against tribal law. We'll go home now. Follow.
I know the way.
Oh, what? Oh, okay, drop the rock. Aim for the head.
My mother.
Aloy, I've told you before, that's not for us to know. You were just a newborn when the matriarchs brought you to me.
So the matriarchs, they know?
It's not so simple.
But they know.
Aloy, we are outcasts.
So how do I make them tell me?
The matriarchs? There is a way, perhaps.
So tell me.
It would be dangerous.
How?
It would take years of training.
I don't care. How do I do it? Tell me.
The proving. The tribe's rite of passage held every year. Those who pass become braves. But to the one who wins, the matriarchs grant a boon.
A boon?
Yes, whatever the winner wants.
Then I'll do it. Whatever it takes. I'll win the proving.
I see. We'd best get started then. Your training will be hard, and it will take years.
Start training? Yes. Follow.
Thank you. 2 days before the proving and he goes off without me? He wouldn't do that.
Oh, level 3! Alrighty. Alright, well this one is definitely useful. What? Create a jab to go get it?